ROE, or return on equity, is computed as net income divided by average shareholders' equity. To know what makes the ROE increase or decrease, we need to decompose the ROE. This decomposition is what we call DuPont analysis. Looking at the DuPont analysis formulas, it seems difficult to remember. Well, don't worry. This video will tell you the tricks or techniques on how to easily memorize the DuPont analysis formulas. Stay tuned and watch the video till the very end. ROE can be expressed in two components using mnemonic REM or REM. R is ROA, or return on assets, while EM stands for equity multiplier. Therefore, we have two fractions or components. To easily memorize the formula, just remember these two very simple tricks. The first trick is start with net income and ends with average shareholder's equity. This means that the first component should have net income as numerator and the last component should have average shareholder's equity as denominator. For the first component, return on assets, what would be the denominator? If you remember the video, How to Easily Memorize the Financial Ratios, it says that ratio that starts with the word return, the denominator is the average of the last word of ratio name. The link of that video is in the description below or click the card above. Since we are talking about return on assets, the denominator is average total assets. Next, we will apply the second trick, which is the denominator of a certain component will become numerator of the next component. Therefore, the next component will have average total assets as numerator. When we do elimination, the final result will be net income over average shareholders' equity, the original formula of ROE. So, this is our formula for two-way decomposition of ROE. Now, how about the three-way decomposition of ROE? This can be done by decomposing the return on assets into two components and bringing down the equity multiplier. We can use the mnemonic NATIM. N stands for net profit margin, AT means asset turnover, and EM for equity multiplier. Applying the first trick, we already comply with the rule that the formula should end with average shareholders' equity. We need to add net income as numerator in the first component. Now, we will apply the second trick, which is the denominator of a certain component will become numerator of the next component. Since equity multiplier has numerator of average total assets, it means that the second component will have denominator of average total assets. Now, how about the first component called net profit margin? If you watch the video How to Easily Memorize the Financial Ratios, it says that ratio that ends with word margin, the denominator is sales or revenue. So, denominator of net profit margin is revenue. Applying the second trick, revenue as denominator will become numerator of the next component. How we will know that this formula is correct? Doing elimination, we end up with the original ROA formula of net income over average shareholders' equity. So, this is our formula of three-way decomposition of ROA. Now, let's go to five-way decomposition of ROE. This can be done by decomposing net profit margin into three components. We can use mnemonic TIE or TIE. T stands for tax burden, I for interest burden, and E is for EBIT margin. Bring down the last two formulas of asset turnover and equity multiplier. Applying the first trick, then you have these incomplete formulas. Let's use again the second trick. The numerator of asset turnover of revenue is also the denominator of prior component of EBIT margin. According to the video, How to Easily Memorize the Financial Ratio, ratio that ends with the word margin, the numerator is the name of the ratio. So, numerator of the third component is EBIT or earnings before interest and taxes. Applying the second trick, EBIT should be the denominator of the second component called interest burden. The first component has denominator of EBT or earnings before tax. Applying the second trick, this denominator will become numerator of the next component. Eliminating EBT, EBIT, revenue, and average total assets will result to the original formula of ROA of net income over average shareholder's equity. So this is our formula of five-way decomposition of ROA. So that's it. I hope these techniques are great helps in acing your exams. Good luck and wish you all the success. If you liked the video, please click the like icon. You can also leave your comment. Please subscribe and click the notification bell icon for more videos. For more videos and financial ratios, click the link on the description below or click this in screens. Thanks for watching.